I'm Everyone should use it.
Everyone should use it.
So I can just talk. So one general comment. So the excellent talk, Christian, and others as well. So you showed this vendor side of things, how you put this development, like, you know, into these kind of service oriented groups. But it's also like, you know, for example, what I'd like to do in the customer side, so in an HPC center, so basically.
Yeah, I use containers on my MacBook, but I cannot use this on Mac.
Okay.
The standard way is that you have a boot to Docker, or you use Docker machine to create a virtual machine running a very small Linux.
Okay. That, I don't understand that. So it's maybe a bit a trivial question, but anyway.
But it's a fair question, sure. But it's the same on Windows. You can have boot to Docker, or use Docker machine to create a virtual machine that only runs, I don't know how, but How big is this Ubuntu Docker image? I think it's 50 megabytes. It's very small, because it just provides the kernel, but nothing, not much more. That's pretty simple. You load the module in the kernel of the host system, and then you expose dev InfiniBand to the container, and that's all everything you need.
And that's no so simple. No security use? I mean, that's probably some kind of privileged access, right?
Yeah, you have to give it the privilege access.
Okay, but because it's a basic service, you don't care much. Okay.
Yeah, and it's an HPC system, supposedly, so...
Let's assume that we're using them. Docker only abstracts the userland. So if the library is in the userland, then you are fine. But the real interesting stuff is going on if you need another kernel module on container 1 and container 2 needs another version of this kernel module, then you are kind of screwed currently. Because if this is not in the namespace of the Linux kernel, then you are screwed.